Namaste. Welcome all of you, the webinar team, and all the participants who are taking part in the webinar, the students, the staff, everyone. In continuation to our journey of learning about circles, we are moving ahead today, further ahead with Deshpande sir's session on circles. So I want that all the children will take part very interestingly in this particular webinar session and improve yourself. So Deshpande Sanjeev Kumar sir, welcome. Please continue, sir. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Children, so last few classes you have been discussing about the chord of contact and polar. So let us solve some problems on these two topics, problems on the chord of contact and the problems on pole and polar. So today it is going to be a problem solving session. So I request all the students to have your pen and paper ready and try to solve the problems along with me. So like to start with what exactly you learned in your previous class, we have learned about what exactly is the angle between the pair of tangents from a point. So the angle between the tangents from a point is given by the relation between r, theta, and root s11. You have got a formula. What is it? Tan theta by 2 is equal to r divided by root over s11. Then we discussed about the chord of contact and the equation of the chord of contact. The equation of chord of contact is given as s1 is equal to 0. And we discussed different cases of the methods of finding the chord of contact in your previous classes. Then we discussed about the pole and polar yesterday's class. So what is polar and what is pole, right? So if you take the pole from the pole, you get the polar, the point of intersection of tangents, you're calling it as polar. And the point from where you're taking the pole is what is called as, from the point you take the polar is what is called as a pole, right? Then we discussed about the equation of polar. It was similar to the equation of tangent and chord of contact. It is S1 is equal to 0. Then we discussed about the equation of circle as, say, x square plus y square is equal to r square. The polar is given by the formula xx1 plus yy1 minus r square is equal to 0. Then we also discussed about finding the pole, the line lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 with respect to the circle. X square plus y square is equal to a square. The formula is minus a square l by n and minus a square m by n. We also discussed the procedure to find the pole. What is it you have done? If the circle is equation is something like s is equal to 0, what you have done? You have taken the equation of polar at a point x1, y1, which is called as pole. Then we compared that equation of polar with the equation given here. You get a proportionality from that solving of that proportionalities, proportionals. You will be getting the values of x1, y1, which was called as a pole. So the procedure we have done in the previous class. So let us practice problems on these things today. Right. So the first of the question here, find the locus of a point if the tangents drawn from P to the circle x square plus y square is equal to a square include an angle alpha. So what is the meaning of this? You have got the tangents drawn from P. The angle made by the tangents is alpha. So you are going to find out the locus of that point. So you just see the figure here. So you got the pair of tangents here. This line QR is a chord of contact, and these are the two tangents. Now here, there's a point where you've got, and this angle is alpha. Now you're saying locus of the point P. That means that this point P is not fixed here. If the point P is somewhere here, then again, you can draw two tangents, and you get the angle as alpha. If you take the point somewhere here, you can draw two tangents. The positions of Q and R also will vary here. Only thing is the angle is going to remain as alpha. So if the angle is same, maintained as alpha throughout, by changing the points, you are going to find what exactly is the locus of P. So what is a path traveled by P if you have this condition fixed? So what is given in the problem here? Equation of circle, x square plus y square is equal to a square. Now you take the point P as x1, y1, and angle as alpha, because already given that angle is alpha. So once you take the point as x1, y1, what is s11? S11 is nothing but in place of x, you put x1, in place of y, you put y1, and bring everything one side. So it is x1 square plus y1 square minus a square. No equal to zero here. Simply, it is S11. Next, what is given? Alpha is the angle between the tangents. So you require S11, you require alpha. You also require third quantity. What is it? Radius. So you got radius as A, you have got S11, you got angle as alpha. So what should be the formula connecting all these three? Tan alpha by 2 is equal to R divided by root over S11. So here, tan alpha by 2 is equal to tan alpha by 2 is equal to R value is A here, and square root of S11 is square root of X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. So you got tan alpha by 2, and this time you, this right hand side, you got a square root. So what you can do is you can square on both sides. When you square on both sides, you get tan square alpha by 2 is equal to A square by X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. Square root and square will cancel off. You get simply the term X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. Now, you need to find out angle alpha, but you have found out alpha by 2 here. So to find out alpha, we take up okay, so we take up the formula cos alpha is equal to 1 minus tan square alpha by 2 by 1 plus tan square alpha by 2. So here you have found out tan square alpha by 2. Substitute the value of tan square alpha by 2 here. So tan square alpha by 2 is a square by x1 square plus y1 square minus a square. So you got tan square alpha by 2 in numerator as well as denominator. We substituted here. Now you take LCM here. What is LCM here? X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. What is the LCM here? Same X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. So when you take LCM, if at all you take, put the value here, this value is going to be X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square divided by X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. Denominator, again, you got in denominator is X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square. You can write as X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square plus A square. So you can cancel off this X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square and X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square later on. So that is what you have done in the next step. You got cos alpha is equal to X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square minus A square. So denominator X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square has gone. With another denominator, same term. So you got X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square in numerator, and denominator X1 square plus Y1 square minus A square plus A square. So you see that there is a minus A square and plus A square. You can cancel off these two, and minus A square is minus 2A square. So you get X1 square plus Y1 square minus 2A square divided by X1 square plus Y1 square. So what is it you can do is you can go for a cross multiplication here. So this X1 square plus Y1 square can be brought onto the left hand side. So X1 square plus Y1 square into cos alpha is equal to X1 square plus Y1 square minus 2A square. Now, one more thing you observe here, you got X1 square plus Y1 square for cos alpha. You have got X1 square plus Y1 square here also. So you can bring this X1 square plus Y1 square this side, left-hand side. So what is it you get? X1 square plus Y1 square is equal to cos alpha minus 1. This is as it is put minus 2A square, right? So this cos alpha minus 1 and you got a negative sign here. So I can write this as 1 minus cos alpha. So x1 square plus y1 square into 1 minus cos alpha is equal to 2a square. Now remember, children, what is the formula you have got for 1 minus cos alpha? In your first year, you have got it. 1 minus cos alpha, you can write as 2 sine square alpha by 2. In your first year trigonometry. So 1 minus cos alpha, you can write as 2 sine square alpha by 2. So here, x1 square plus y1 square into 2 sine square alpha by 2 is equal to 2a square. So you got a 2 here and you got a 2 here. You can cancel out both the 2s here. Now this cos square alpha, you can transfer to other side. So what you get is a square by sine square alpha by 2. So 1 by sine is always a cosecant term. So we can simply write, you can write it as x1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square into this sine goes other side. 1 by sine is going to be cosecant. So cosecant square alpha by 2. So you got a general equation here. If you take the point as x1, y1, you got this equation. If you take the point as x2, y2, you get x2 square plus y2 square is equal to a square into cosecant square of alpha by 2. So moment you change the point here, this term is going to change and this term is going to be fixed. Now generalize it here. So because you're saying locus, so instead of x1, you can write as x. Instead of y1, you can write as y. So the locus of the point is x square plus y square is equal to a square into cosecant square alpha by 2. So children, have you understood this method, this problem? So if you understood, then we can go for the next problem here. Now, the question is, find the coordinates of the point of intersection of tangents at the points where x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0 meets the circle x square plus y square minus 2x plus 3y minus 5 is equal to 0. Now, what is the difference between this problem and the previous problem here? The previous problem, you have been given the condition as the angle made is alpha here. Now, what is that you are saying is, you are not putting any condition that the angle made is alpha. So you are only just measuring the angle between the two tangents, not angle between the two tangents. You are going to find the place where the two coordinates are intersecting. So that point of intersection you are finding. So finding the point of intersection of the tangents. So what is given here? Equation of circle, x square plus y square minus 2x plus 3y minus 5 is equal to 0. So 2g value is minus 2. So g value is minus 1. 2f is 3. F value is 3 by 2. And c value is minus 5. Now what is given is the line x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0. This line meets the given circle. So see here, the line given here, x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0 is meeting the circle. Now from this point Q and from this point R, wherever they are meeting, you are drawing tangents. These tangents are meeting at a point. What is that point? P. So you are going to find this value of P. So let P x1 y1 be the point of intersection of the tangent. So where the tangents are meeting, they are meeting at the point P. Okay, so to find the point here, so you can say that this QR is going to be a chord of contact also. So you find with respect to the circle from the point a chord of contact equation. So what is chord of contact equation is given as S1 is equal to 0. So what is the formula of S1 is equal to 0? You've got xx1 plus yy1 plus g times x plus x1 plus f times y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. Okay, now you know what is the value of g, f, c. What is that you don't know? You don't know what is the value of x1, y1. We are going to find out. So put the value of g, f, c here. So you get x, x1 plus y, y1 minus 1 into x plus x1 plus 3 by 2 into y plus y1 minus 5 is equal to 0. Now see here, you got a 3 by 2 here. So you can take LCM of the entire thing here. So once you take LCM here, this LCM is 2 you get. Here you can have 2xx1 plus 2yy1 minus 1 into 2 is 2. So minus 2 you get x plus x1. So minus 2x minus 2x1, then 3y1 minus 2 into 5 is 10 is equal to 0. So 2xx1 plus 2yy1 minus 2x minus 2x1 plus 3y plus 3y1 minus 10 is equal to 0. After taking the LCM, so denominator 2 can go to right hand side. So you see that there is a x here as well as here. You can take x common. So you can write as 2x1 minus 2 of x. You find a y here and a y here. You can write 2y1 plus 3 of y. Then all the constant terms minus 2x1 plus 3y1 minus 10 is equal to 0. This is what is equation 2. Now, we are saying that the QR is given by the line x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0. The QR is also a chord of contact and it is given by this line. So it means that there are two chord of contacts. You cannot have two chord of contacts. So it means that 1 and 2 are almost representing same equation. So it means that the coefficient of 1 and coefficient of 2 are proportional. So what is the meaning of it? So we can write 2x1 minus 2 by 1 is equal to 2y1 plus 3 by 4 is equal to minus 2x1 plus 3y1 minus 10 divided by minus 14. Okay, now how is it you solve this? So since last few classes you have been solving this type of problem, how is it you solve it? Children, so you take any two pairs. So I take the first pair. So let us take the first pair, 2x1 minus 2 divided by 1 is equal to 2y1 plus 3 by 4. So cross multiply. So 4 into 2x1 minus 2 is equal to 1 into 2y1 plus 3. So 4 into 2 is 8, 8x1 minus 8, 2y1 plus 3. So you get you get 8x1 minus 8 is equal to 2y1 plus 3. So bring everything one side, 8x1 minus 2y1 minus 8 minus 3 is minus 11 is equal to 0. This is what is the first equation in terms of x1, y1. Now take the second equation. So how is you take another pair? So for another pair, we take 2x1 minus 2 divided by 1 is equal to minus 2x1 plus 3y1 minus 10 divided by minus 14. So cross multiply. So minus 14 into 2x1 minus 2 is equal to 1 into minus 2x1 plus 3y1 minus 10. So minus 14 into 2x1 is minus 14 into 2 is minus 28x1. Then minus 14 into minus 2 is plus 28. Then you got minus 2x1 plus 3y1 minus 10 on the right hand side. So just bring this minus 28x1 onto the right hand side. You get 28 minus 2, which is 26x1 plus 3y1 plus 28 goes to the right hand side. It is going to become minus 10 minus 28, which is minus 38 is equal to 0. So you got another equation in terms of x1, y1. So solve these two equations, x1, y1. Children, solve these two equations, get the value of x1 and y1. So how is it you solve it? First, sequence is 2, 3, 1, 2. 2, 3, 1, 2 sequence you have to follow. So what is 2, 3, 1, 2 sequence? Minus 2, minus 11, 8, minus 2. Likewise, 3, minus 38, and 26, and 3. Next step is going to be cross multiplication. So you're going to multiply minus 2 into minus 38, 3 and minus 11, minus 11 into 26, minus 38 and 8 with a negative sign, 8 and 3 and 26 and minus 2 with a negative sign. So the first sum you're going to get is x1 divided by. So x1 divided by minus 2 into minus 38 is 76. 3 into minus 11 is minus 33, but you are going opposite direction. So it is going to be minus of minus, so plus 33. Then y1 divided by minus 11 into 26 is minus 286. Then you got minus 38 into 8, which is nothing but minus 304, but you are going opposite direction. So you get minus of minus. So it is plus 304. Then 1 divided by 8 into 3 is 24, and minus 26 into minus 2 is minus 52, but you are going opposite direction. So minus of minus is plus 52. So 76 plus 33 is 109. And minus 286 plus 304 is 18, and 24 plus 52 is 76. So 109, 18, 76. So you want to find the value of x1. So x1 by 109 is 1 by 76, or x1 is equal to 109 by 76. Y1 by 18 is equal to 1 by 76. So y1 is going to be 18 divided by 76. So the point of intersection of the tangents, which you called as P, is nothing but 109 by 76, 109 by 76, comma 18 divided by 76. So have you understood this, children? Solving part, you need to be a little faster, right? You have been doing this many number of times. Now, so let us take a problem here. If the polar of the points on the circle, x square plus y square is equal to a square, with respect to the circle, x square plus y square is equal to b square, touches the circle x square plus y square is equal to c square, then prove that a, b, c are in geometric progression. So this is usually asked a general question for a 4 marks. Sometimes they give it for 7 marks, but usually it is asked for 4 marks in the IP examination. So first of all, understand the question. What is the question given here? The polar of the point on the circle. So the point is on the circle. Which circle it is? X square plus y square is equal to a square. From that point, you are going to find polar to the second circle. What is second circle? X square plus y square is equal to b square. And that polar is touching the third circle. Third circle is x square plus y square is equal to c square. Now what you have to show is the relation between a, b, c are in the geometric progression. So let us try to understand this. Figure. Yeah, see, this is what is the first circle. Point x1, y1 is lying on the first circle. Now, this point, from this point, you are drawing a polar to the second circle. Second circle is x square plus y square is equal to p square. So, what is polar? It is something like a point of intersection of tangents. But because you see that this what is a chord of contact, so we can call this as a polar. Now, this polar is also touching the third circle. Third circle is x square plus y square is equal to c square. Okay, so you're going to have the relation between this a, b, c. So understand this properly. Okay, so let us try to solve the problem. So first, what is given here? So you take the point as x1, y1. So let p, x1, y1 be a point on the circle. So whenever you say that anything is a point on circle, it has to satisfy that equation. So you can replace x with x1 and y with y1. So you can write the equation, the point as xx1 plus yy1 is equal to a square. Xx1 plus yy1 is equal to a square. Now, what is the next sentence given here? The second sentence is, from this point, you are going to find the polar of the second circle. So equation of polar of P with respect to circle, x square plus y square is equal to b square. The formula is xx1 plus yy1 minus b square. Because circle radius is b here, so you're going to have minus b square. So the first equation is xx1 plus yy1 is equal to a square. And second equation is xx1 plus yy1 minus b square. Now see third condition. This is going to touch circle. X square plus y square is equal to c square. So this line, the polar line which you are going to have, which you have got, is going to touch the third circle. So what is the condition that any line touches a circle? Remember, the radius is equal to the perpendicular distance from the center. So since the polar of x square plus y square is equal to b square, it touches the circle, x square plus y square is equal to c square. So it means that radius is equal to perpendicular distance from center. What is center of this circle? 0, 0. Right? Of the circle, x square plus y square is equal to c square. To which equation? The polar equation. So equation 2. So what is the radius of the third circle? Third circle radius is c. So you can say c is equal to x1 value is z. You got this equation. So the value of x is 0. The value of y is 0. So xx1 plus yy1 plus c divided by root over a square plus b square. That is the formula here. So 0 into x1 plus 0 into y1 minus b square divided by coefficient of x is x1. So x1 square and coefficient of y is y1. So y1 square, both in the under root. So you got the value of c as now here minus b square divided by root over x1 square plus y1 square. But we have given that x1 square plus y1 square, you have got, what is it you got? X square plus y square is equal to a square, is not so? So when you say x square plus y square is equal to a square, it means that you can put the value of x square plus y square as a square. So put the value as a square. So c is equal to minus b square by root over a square. This equation is unnecessary. Okay, fine. So here, in place of x, you can put x1. In place of y, you can put y1. You get a square. So you can write x1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square. Why? Because this is point on the circle. So c is equal to minus b square by root over a square. Now you can write c is equal to minus b square, in the modulus is there. So you can write b square by a. So you can write b square is equal to ac. So what is the meaning of this b square is equal to ac? Whenever you got three terms in arithmetic progression, say you got a, b, c in arithmetic progression, what is the meaning of it? In geometric progression, not arithmetic progression. If a, b, c are in geometric progression, the condition you have got is second term by the first term is equal to third term by second term. That means that the common ratio should be same. So b by a should be equal to c by b. So cross multiply, b into b is b square, is a into c. So b square is equal to ac. It's a if and only if condition. If you got a, b, c in GP, then you'll have b square is equal to ac. If you have got b square is equal to ac, then you can say a, b, c are in GP. So you got same conditions, b square is equal to ac. So if b square is equal to ac, what is it you can say? The terms a, b, c are in the geometric progression. So you can say a, b, c are in geometric progression. So have you understood this problem here? Very simple problem here. Only thing is, this equation 1, you need to take here. In place of x, you're going to put x1. In place of y, you put y1. X1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square. Okay, so let us take another problem here. Find the locus of the point whose polars with respect to circles. What are circle equations given? X square plus y square minus 4x minus 4y minus 8 is equal to 0. And x square plus y square minus 2x plus 6y minus 2 is equal to 0 are mutually perpendicular. Now here you got two circles. For both the circles, you are going to find the polars. For you got polar as a line, is not so? Straight line. So what is it you have to show is the polar of the first circle and the polar of second circle are mutually perpendicular. Right? Whenever they are mutually perpendicular, you are going to find the locus of the points whose polars are perpendicular. So you are going to find the locus of the points. So you take the point, general point as, the point is a variable here. So the point you take it as x1, y1. Then from the x1, y1, you're going to find the polar of the first line, first circle. Then from the same point, you're going to find the polar of the second circle. Then you have to take the condition that these two are, which two, the polars are mutually perpendicular. So given equation of circle is first equation, x square plus y square minus 4x minus 4y minus 8 is equal to 0. And second equation, x square plus y square minus 2x plus 6y minus 2 is equal to 0. See, remember, whenever a problem is given, it is must and should that you are going to write what is given. So every time I'm, even though question it is already given here, I'm writing this equation number one, equation two, given the equation circle. So make it as a point. So you are going to write what is given in the problem. So you take a point, let px1, y1 be the point. So let px1, y1 be any point. So from this point, you're going to find the polar of the first circle. So equation of polar of P with respect to circle one. What is the formula? XX1 plus YY1 plus G times X plus X1 plus F times Y plus Y1 plus C is equal to zero. So the first equation, what is the value of G? 2G is minus four, so G is minus two. 2F is minus four, so F is minus two and C value is minus eight. So substitute here. So first of all, you write general equation. So xx1 plus yy1, g value is minus 2, x plus x1, f value is minus 2, y plus y1, minus 8 is equal to 0. So you got x at the first place and x at the third place. X at the first place and x at the third place. So you got xx1 minus 2x1. So you can take x common from these two. So you can write x1 minus 2 of x plus y1 minus 2 of y, then minus 2x1 minus 2y1 minus 8 is equal to 0. What is the equation number 3? Likewise, you are going to find the polar of the second circle also with some same point. So equation of polar of P with respect to circle 2. Circle 2 is, now here, 2g is minus 2, 2f is 6, and c value is minus 2. So what is the value of g here? G value should be equal to half of this, minus 1. F value is 3 and c value is minus 2. So it is x, x1 plus y, y1 minus 1 into x plus x1. Then plus 3 into y plus y1 minus 2 is equal to 0. So again, like equation 3 here also, you're going to rearrange here. You got xx1 and you got minus x. So you take x common. So you get x1 minus 1 of x plus y1 plus 3 of y minus x1 plus 3y1 minus 2 is equal to 0. So you have got two equations in terms of x1 and y1. Now what you have to show? What is a given condition? First of all, these two polars are mutually perpendicular. So when can you say two lines are perpendicular? So the equation 3 and equation 4 is like this. So you can say that given the polars of two circles are perpendicular, that is equation 3 is perpendicular to equation 4. So whenever you say two lines are perpendicular, what is a condition? Remember, in the first year you got a condition. Whenever you got a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 as two lines, what is the condition for perpendicularity? Do you remember? So two lines, a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 are perpendicular. If at all, this condition, what is that? Coefficient of x, coefficient of x. So a1 into a2 plus b1 into b2 is equal to 0. So a1 a2 plus b1 b2 is equal to 0. This is a condition. Now compare with the problem given here. So what is the coefficient of x here? It is x1 minus 2. So a1 value is x1 minus 2. And this, what is a2? X1 minus 1. What is b1? Y1 minus 2. What is b2? Y1 plus 3. So you can write x1 minus 2 into x1 minus 1 plus y1 minus 2 into y1 plus 3 is equal to 0. So multiply these two equations. So x1 into x1 is x1 square. Then x1 into minus 1 is minus x1 minus 2x1 plus 2. Likewise, y1 square. Then y1 into 3 is 3y1 minus 2y1 plus. So minus 2 into 3 is minus 6 is equal to 0. So you see that there is x1 square. Then you can have y1 square. Then you got minus x1, minus 2x1, which is minus 3x1. Then you got 3y1, minus 2y1, which is y1. Then you got 2 and minus 6, which is minus 4 is equal to c. So you got an equation now here. Now what is asked here? Find the locus of the point. So the point P is not fixed. The point P is moving. Moment you change the point P, you'll have different things here. So instead of x1, you may have x2. Instead of y1, you have y2. But you are going to find a locus of all those points. So the all those P is locus. What does it do? You drop this x1 right as x and drop this y1 right as y. So you get the equation of the locus of the point as x squared plus y squared minus 3x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0. So what sort of equation it is? The locus is a, again a circle, right? With some center and radius. So the locus of the point of intersection of the polars, if at all they are perpendicular, you have got it as a circle equation. So have you understood this, children, here? So let us take another problem here. The tangents are drawn to the circle x square plus y square is equal to 16 from point 3 comma 5. Find the area of the triangle formed by these tangents and the chord of contact. So again, you see that you're going to draw tangents from the circle from point 3 comma 5, and you got a chord of contact. So you got a figure, a triangle between the tangents and chord of contact. So you are going to find the area of the triangle formed by these tangents and the chord of contact. So what is given information? Let us write. So equation of circle is x square plus y square is equal to 16. Now see here. This is what is a two tangents and this is what is a chord of contact. You got a triangle. You are going to find the area of the triangle. So how to find area of triangle? Area of triangle is given as half into base into height. Okay, so base, what is a base here? The QR is a base. Okay, so QR, base is a chord, right? So you can find the length of this chord. Height. Height is nothing but the distance from the point to the chord. Which distance? Whenever you say distance, it is always perpendicular distance. So the perpendicular distance from the point to the QR is P. You are assuming it. And to get the base, you're going to find the length of the chord. So first of all, you're going to find this length. So the value of P. Then we try to find out length QR. So how to find a length P? So what is center of the circle given? Center of circle is given as 0, 0. See, circle equation is x squared plus y squared is equal to 16. So center is 0, 0. So radius. Radius is 4. So you have got R square value is 16. So equation of chord of contact. So first of all, you are going to find equation of QR. Right? So the point is given. From this point, you are going to find a chord of contact, the QR equation for the circle x square plus y square is equal to 16. So equation of chord of contact from x1 y1 to the circle is given by the formula xx1 plus yy1 minus r square is equal to 0. Why minus r square? Because you got simple equation of circle. So center is 0, 0. Then equation is given like this. Okay. Now, what is x1 y1 here? The point. The r square value is given as 16. Substitute it here. So equation of chord of contact from P3, 5 to the circle is 3x in place of x1, 3 in place of y1, 5 in place of r square, 16. So you got the chord of contact equation as 3x plus 5y minus 16 is equal to 0. Now it is not only the chord of contact equation you want. You want to find this length P. So what is this P here? This P is nothing but the perpendicular distance from the point capital P 3 comma 5 to the line chord of contact 3x plus 5y minus 16 is equal to C. So let P is equal to perpendicular distance from which point 3 comma 5 to which equation the chord of contact. So how to get the perpendicular distance? You have got a formula. You put the value of x1 as 3, y1 as 5. So you can write it as modulus of 3 into 3 plus 5 into 5 minus 16 divided by root over 3 square plus 5 square. So 3 into 3 is 9. 5 into 5 is 25 minus 16. So 9 plus 25 minus 16 is 18 divided by root over 34. So you got the distance from P to this line QR as 18 divided by 234. Now you got the height. What you want is base. Area of triangle is half into base into height. So base is required. So what is base here? Chord. So to get the chord here from the center, you drop a perpendicular onto the chord. You can see here from C, you're dropping a perpendicular. You get CD. So you need to find D here, distance here. So once you know distance D here, you know radius of the circle. So you can find out what is QD or what is QR from this. You got a formula for this. Okay. So D you're supposed to find out. So D is nothing but length of the perpendicular from center. What is center? 0, 0 to what? Again, the chord of contact, equation 1. So how to find length? Again, the same formula. Ax1 plus by1 plus c by root over a square plus b square. Here, x1 by1 is 0, 0. So 3 into 0 plus 5 into 0 minus 16 divided by 3 square plus 5 square. So what do you get the answer as? 16 divided by root over 34. So you got d value here. So you can take square. D square is 16 square, 256 by 34. So the length of the chord, you got a formula. Remember, 2 times square root of r square minus d square. So r square value 16, d square value is 256 by 34. So you take LCM here. LCM is 34. So you get 2 into root over 16 into 34 is 544 minus 256 divided by 34. So 544 minus 256 is 288. So 288 by 34. So 288 you can write as 144 into 2. So 144 square root is 12. So 12 root 2 divided by root 34. So 2 into 12 is 24. 24 root 2 divided by root 34. So you got QR value now here. Right, so the base you got now here, the height you got of the triangle. So area of the triangle, this triangle PQR, the angle triangle made between the tangents and the chord of contact. So it is half into base into height. So what is the base here? QR. And what is the height here? P. So you know what is the value of P and what is the value of QR. So half into QR is 24 root 2 divided by root 34 into 18 divided by root 34. So you got root 34, root 34 twice. So 1 by 2 into 24 into 18 into root 2 by 34. So you can cancel off one of the two, sir. So you get the answer as 108 square root of 2 divided by 34 square units. So 1, 2 got cancelled, you got 12. 1, 2 got cancelled, you got 9 here, and you get 34 half is 17. So 12, 9 j is 108. So 108 root 2 square units. So 108 root 2 by 17 square units. So area of the triangle is 108 root 2 by 17 square units. So have you understood this? This is also one of the possible question in the examination for a 4-mark section. So let us take one more problem here. Find the locus of the foot of the perpendicular drawn from origin to any chord of the circle x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0, which subtend a right angle at origin. Subtend a right angle at origin. So you are drawing perpendiculars from origin to any chord. So this problem you need to connect to the concept of first year. So whenever you are using the word drawn from origin or subtending a right angle at origin, we are going to use a concept of homogenizing. So just recollect the concepts of a homogenizing process. Where exactly you had homogenizing process? You had in your pair of straight lines. Okay, so let us try to solve the problem here. So let P, X1, Y1 be the foot of the perpendicular from origin onto the chord. So you see chord is QR, and from where you are doing 0, 0. So you call this point as X1, Y1. So you are going to find the locus of this point. So what is the meaning of it? See, this is a chord QR. Instead of this, if you have got chord like this, your point P will be here. If you have got chord like this, your point will be here. If you got chord like this, your point will be there. So this point is not fixed. Only thing is, the circle is fixed, the origin is fixed, the perpendicularity is fixed. So the chord changes along with the point. So when the point is changing, chord is also changing. So you're going to find the locus of this point. Now you find slope of OP. So how to find slope of the line? You got a formula, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So you can write y minus 0 by x1 minus 0. So y1 minus 0 by x1 minus 0 is simply y1 by x1. Now you have got slope of OP. Now what is the QR here? Because chord is always, the line is always perpendicular to chord here. You said perpendicular. So the OP is always perpendicular to QR. So slope of QR will be equal to just reciprocal of this with a negative sign. So it is minus of, exchange the positions, so minus of x1 by y1. Why it is so? Because OP is perpendicular to QR, right? So understood this step here. So you got y1 by x1, and here you got minus x1 by y1. Now you got the slope of the line and point. So when slope and point are known, what is the equation of circle? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Remember in the first year you got. So what is slope here? Minus x1 by y1. So y minus y1 is equal to minus x1 by y1 into x minus x1. So cross multiply. So y1 into y minus y1 is equal to minus x1 into x minus x1. So rearrange this. So you can write y into y1 minus y1 square is equal to minus x into x1 plus x1 square. So rearrange. You can write xx1 plus yy1 is equal to x1 square plus y1 square. Now you can write this as xx1 plus yy1 by x square, x1 square plus y1 square is equal to 1. This is a very, very important step in the homogenizing process. So right hand side, you have to always get 1. Okay. Now, which equation has to be homogenized? This equation. So you are going to convert the circular equation into a homogeneous equation. So you take circular equation x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Right? So how does it you homogenize it here? So you are going to have same degree every time. So you put a 1 here, put a 1 here. Here you're going to put 1 square. Same thing I wrote here, x square plus y square. Now because you got single degree term here, also single degree term here, you club the 2gx and 2fy into 1. Separately, we not write 1 here and 1 here. Commonly, you can write it. If you wish, you can write it separately. It doesn't make a difference. So it is 2gx plus 2fy into 1. Now, c is not having any variable. So you are going to put 1 square. So what is it you ensure from this? You put this one value here and make this equation 2 as a homogeneous equation. So what do you mean by homogeneous equation? The degree of all the terms will be same, right? If the degree is 2 here, every time the degree will be 2. If the degree is 3, every time the degree will be 3. If the degree is 1, every step degree term is going to be 1. Okay, so you are going to have the homogeneous. So here degree is 2, here is degree is 2 here. So everywhere the degree should be same, 2. Okay, so that is what is the step you are going to do is homogenizing equation 2 using equation 1. So you see x1, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy Now see the step one, you are writing it as xx1 plus yy1 divided by x1 square plus y1 square. Then c into xx1 plus yy1 by x1 square plus y1 square whole square is equal to c. So you are going to rearrange this entire expression, write only the coefficients of x square and y square. See, you require only x square terms and y square terms. No x y terms are required, right? So you should be very smart here. No need of writing x y term. You are going to write only the x square term and y square term. Why you are writing only x square term and y square term? Because you have to show that the locus is perpendicular. So perpendicular requires only the coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square. Okay, so for that term, you take the first term. Now here, the first term you see here, there is x square. So you can write the x square taking common here. So coefficient is 1. Next here, you see that there is 2x, 2gx and xx1. So when you multiply x and x, you get x square. So it is going to be 2gx1 x square. So x square already written here. Denominator is x1 square plus y1 square. Now see here, you got c, x, x1 square is there. Okay, so you can write this as c, x square, x1 square. X square is written here. So c, x1 square by denominator is x1 square plus y1 square whole square. Same is the case with y here. So here y square, right? So coefficient of y square is 1, then here you got y term. Here also you got y term. So multiply these two terms, only 2fy and yy1. So what you get is y square. So 2fy1 y square and denominator x1 square plus y1 square. So 2fy1 by x1 square plus y square, y1 square. Where is y square taken common? Then here also, if you square this, y square, y1 square and c. So y square is already taken common. So c y1 square by x1 square plus y1 square whole square. Then I'm not interested in what is the xy term. So I wrote a coefficient of xy is equal to 0. So try to understand this step properly here. So I repeat here. So first of all, you are going to take x square term, coefficients of all x square terms. So here you got x square term. Excuse me. You got x square term here. Here, when you multiply 2gx and xx1, you get x square. And when you take square of this, you get x1 square. So you take all such x square terms. So the first term, no coefficient is there, means always 1 you can put. Then you got 2gx and xx1. So x and x is x square. So 2gx1, denominator will be as it is there. So x1 square plus y1 square. Okay, so here also you got x square term. Then here, c is there, x1 square plus y1 square whole square is there. Now see here, when you square this term, because you got a plus b whole square, so you get a square. So a square is going to be square of this. So x square, x1 square. So already I've taken x square out. What is left out? X1 square. And c is also there. So c, x1 square divided by x1 square plus y1 square whole square. Okay, so have you understood this? Second term is simply replacing g with f and x1 with y1. So you get 2gx1, here you get 2fy1. Simply logic, no need of writing all steps again, doing this. Once you understand this step, once you are able to do this, second is simply repetition here. Only in place of g, you're going to put f. In place of x1, you're going to put y1. Right? Everywhere it is same. Right? Now, you can say equation 2 represents a pair of perpendicular lines. It is given. It represents a pair of perpendicular lines. So when can you say any second degree equation representing a pair of perpendicular lines? See, you see this is a second degree equation. Why I am calling it a second degree equation? Degree is 2 here, degree is 2 here, and here degree is also 2 because x and y are multiplied. So it has become a homogeneous equation. So equation 2 is a homogeneous equation. So once it is homogeneous equation, the task of homogenizing is over, right? So the homogeneous equation, whatever you got, there represents a pair of perpendicular lines. So when can you say their pair as perpendicular lines, pair of perpendicular lines? Coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y square is zero. So you remember it as a plus b is equal to zero. So it represents a pair of perpendicular lines if coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y square is equal to zero. So if you take equation as ax square plus 2hxy plus by square is equal to zero, recollect your first year textbook concept. So ax square, coefficient of x square is a, by square, coefficient of y square is b. So a plus b is zero. So coefficient of x square is given here, coefficient of y square is given here. So you can write 1 plus 2gx1 plus 1 plus 2gx1 by x1 square plus y1 square plus cx1 square by x1 square plus y1 square whole square plus second coefficient. Now, you see here, you got x1 square plus y1 square, x1 square plus y1 square, same denominator. So you can write commonly x1 square plus y1 square. Numerators, you can add 2gx1 and 2fy1. Next, this is having square, this is also having square, commonly you can write. So you can write x1 square plus y1 square whole square in numerator. And in these two terms, you got c common. See, third term and sixth term, you got c common. So you can take c common, right? X1 square plus y1 square. Now you got same x1 square plus y1 square and x1 square plus y1 square whole square. So I can cancel out one of the square here. And what is that you get is c divided by x1 square plus y1 square. So take the LCM. So when you take LCM, you get 2 times x1 square plus y1 square plus 2gx1 plus 2fy1 plus c is equal to c. Okay, so you got an equation. Now, if you change the point, then this subscript will go and you get some other. So you take locus of this equation. What you get is 2 times x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. So if you change the positions of p, what sort of equation you get? Again, you get a circle equation. The circle equation is not same. Only thing is you got 2 here. Doesn't make a difference. Coefficient of x square, coefficient of y square are same. Of course, the condition should be satisfied. That is g square plus f square minus c should be greater than 0. Okay, so the condition will be satisfied. So this is going to be a circle equation. Okay, so this is one of the problem, rare problem which you find in this topic, right? So rest all problems are easy except this problem, little understanding is required in this problem here. So you need to be more careful in solving this problem, right? So with this, we just have a recapitulation of what you have taken today. So we have done only practice, okay? So practice problems on what concepts? The angle between the tangents, chord of contact, and polar and polar. So you need to resolve this, revisit, and try to make up the problems, write notes, solve the problems on your own. It is going to be helpful for you. So let us take some practice problems. So find the locus of P if the tangents drawn from P to circles are perpendicular to each other. So it is similar to the question to the previous one here. Tangents are perpendicular to each other. So this problem we have discussed today. So the first question or second question, I believe you have done it. Show that the poles of the tangents to circles with respect to circles lie on. So you are going to find the poles of the tangents of circle and this circle, they lie on this line. So just try to find this question. Then third one, this one. So these two questions are solved questions in the textbook. You have got a doubt, you can actually refer the textbook and try to understand it. Okay, so with this, I'd like to conclude today's session. The next session, we're going to learn about conjugate points and conjugate lines, which are very, very important again. So action is a foundational key of to all the success. You need to have the action if at all you want to be successful. Sir?
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. there was a question about
about
what is the meaning of homogenizing one, and another one, when you are teaching about the chord subtending a perpendicular in the origin, they were asking about why a perpendicular should be drawn on the chord. So this were the doubts that came out in the session.
Yeah, the perpendicular, which question, sir?
Perpendicular to the chord. Why are we?
Yeah, first is homogenizing is nothing but a concept. Yeah, the first question, the homogenizing is a procedure where a non-homogeneous equation is converted to a homogeneous equation. Say if at all you have got an equation of a straight line, simple example. So you got AX plus BY plus C is equal to zero. So what is the degree of X and Y? So degree of X and Y is one. But constant term is there. So degree of constant is zero. So you can say that there are two different degrees. One is degree one and second is degree zero. Say you take another example. Say X square plus Y square is equal to five. Degree of X square is two and degree of Y square is two. And constant term is having degree zero. So there is a variation. So whenever you got the variation of degrees, you can go for homogenizing, right? So you need to just recollect your first year concepts or go through your first year pair of straight lines I just mentioned. There you clearly get all these examples, right? Second question, not get this question.
It is about why should we draw a perpendicular to the chord. I think this is with the same problem.
The same problem.
Yes.
Foot of perpendicular. So here it is mentioned foot of perpendicular drawn. So the word foot of the perpendicular here, it means that this point PX1Y1 is foot of the perpendicular. So already mentioned that this is perpendicular. The word is mentioned. Okay. So we are going to find the locus of this foot of the perpendicular. Foot of perpendicular is points. So it is word mentioned in the question itself.
Problem itself.
Yeah. So that reason you have taken perpendiculars.
Okay. So these were the only two doubts that had come out in the chat.
Sorry.
So it was a very interesting session. And the students also were able to understand. They were only these two doubts which had actually come up. So with an interesting session, I think we can wind up the session now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So thank you very much, sir. And I want that the students will do the homework. And if you've got any concluding remarks, you may please tell.
Yeah, like the solutions for this questions which have been there, you find in the textbook as solved problems. Even if at all you're not able to get, I'll give the solutions. I'll give the final answers in the chat box. To try to practice.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.